my channel. Thank you so much for being here. And if you're new here, hello. My name is Ashley. I run things here at Okra Gal. I know. The hair is a mess. I know, like, my hair looks like this a lot of the time, but that's usually like at the end of a what I eat in a day video, not like the beginning of a grocery haul. Just to not feel like putting the makeup on today. I mean, I showered, so like one in the point column, but didn't care about the hair, didn't care about my makeup. Especially, I feel like, I mean, I like doing my makeup when, even when I'm staying home, because it just makes me feel better. But when I know I'm gonna have to go out and go to the store and put a mask on over said makeup, it's like, why? Like, why even try? This is all the foundation and concealer is gonna be messed up anyway, so what's the point? It's Friday for me, it's going up on Monday. This video is going up on Monday per usual. And I'm really liking, I mean, it's really been since quarantine started that we've been shopping on Fridays. When Cernan was going, he was going on Friday, and now I'm going on Friday. I just feel like, especially now with having to stand in line, you tend to beat the crowds on a Friday versus like a Saturday or a Sunday, and I'm really liking it, and I'm liking how I still have Saturday and Sunday to like do other things, like meal prep and that sort of thing. I don't feel as rushed. So I'm really enjoying that. I'm also really enjoying this. Last week I was drinking a hard kombucha during my grocery haul, and the same is happening this week. I will put up a picture on the screen of what this actually looks like. I have it in my Brewmate so you can't see, but this is by a local company. It's a hard kombucha and it's in strawberry mojito, and it is a delicious. So I'm enjoying that. Cernan and Daisy ran to Costco. We were out of applesauce and a handful of other things. So they're doing that. And yeah, let's just go ahead and start chatting. I do want to talk about a handful of things initially here. So if you're not interested in that, if you don't want to listen to me talk, you just want to see the haul, I will leave a timestamp as always in the description box for you guys. But I have a list on my little whiteboard of don't forget to tell them about that stuff. So first off, brownies. I mentioned a couple weeks back, I bought the pure brownie mix. I made them. They are great. They are delicious. But following that, when I did my Barron's like local market haul, I picked up the Birch Benders brownie in a cup. That blows the pure ones out of the water. Price-wise, it's probably more cost efficient to buy the pure ones, but the Birch Benders brownie in a cup is like next level. It does not taste erythritol-y. It doesn't taste like you're eating something keto. I know that that is not the most descriptive phrasing, but like you guys know what I mean. Like you can like taste the oil or the butter or the erythritol. It is absolutely delicious. If you see one while you're out, now I can't attest to like the cookie in a cup or the muffin one. They have other ones as well, but the brownie is top notch. All right, before we chat about my list and where I went in my haul and all that jazz, I had to mention these because these are like, they're so good. These are the Foster Farms Takeout Crispy Wings in Classic Buffalo. I hauled these recently in a grocery haul. I had like a couple of random things that we picked up from Costco, and this was one of them. I mentioned that video when I saw these, like when I walked past them, I was like, there's no way, because crispy, like when there's crispy in the title, they've usually been breaded. But per serving, these are 4 net carbs, and they will blow your socks off. They are so good. They really are crispy. I do them in the air fryer. I have not cooked them in the oven yet. I've only cooked them in the air fryer. I do them at 385 for 15 minutes, and then I flip them and do them for 10 minutes. They are fully cooked, but that temperature and time combination, crispy, like when you take them out, they're like glistening and like bubbling. They are so good. So if you see these at your local Costco, or even if you don't see like a bulk size bag and you see a smaller bag just at the regular grocery store, and you're a Buffalo Wing fan, you will not be disappointed. We just had them 2 nights ago, and we had them a time before that. So clearly there's a lot of portions in here. I'm so glad that I thought to look at the macros, because otherwise I would just like kept on walking. Okay, so this was my list for the week. The things in the clouds are just little reminders for me. This is like my meals for each day. This is a tattoo Daisy made me put on my hand. And then all of this, these are the items that I actually have to get. This is a very short list, which I like. I like having a short list. Especially when I go to grocery outlet, because you never know what they're gonna have, and it gives me a little bit more leniency to toss random fun things in my cart that I find. So, what we're eating this week: wings and salad, buffalo chicken meatballs and a vegetable, pizza and salad, breakfast for dinner, enchiladas and black beans, and then on the last meal for the week, I just put open, which just means what meat can you find at grocery outlet. I like to do that every now and then because they usually have really good pre-marinated meats, really good prices on their meat, and so I'd rather like scope out and see what they have instead of like planning out a meal for that day. All right, let's jump into the haul. I'm not gonna do prices today. I normally share prices when I go to grocery outlet because they itemize their receipt like by section, by department or whatever, but I am like on borrowed time. Like Cernan and Daisy will be home any minute and I would just rather like get it done. However, that being said, it is grocery outlet and I remember the prices of a lot of things because like that's why I go there, because stuff's so cheap. So if it was like real notable, I'm gonna tell you how much it was. Okay, let's do it. Okay, starting with produce. I did not want four red onions, but they did not sell them individually, so I had to get a four pack. So we have that, some green onions, bananas for Daisy. I got two bags of chopped salad, the Caesar and the avocado ranch. Both of these are 6 net carbs per serving. Dairy, I got two things of eggs, again, because I'm doing egg salad, that takes a lot of eggs. Two things of cream cheese and some Colby Jack. Meat-wise, most of the meat I'm using this week is in my freezer, so I did not have to pick up really anything. So this was the like free meal night, like what do they have there? I've had this before, I love this brand. It's the Adaptable Meals Roasted Garlic and Herb Boneless Pork Loin Chops, so we'll be having those. And then this was $1 off for quick sale, so it was $2. I'm just gonna toss this in the freezer and figure out what to do with it at a later date. Okay, I picked up some shredded hash browns. These were in the refrigerated section. Definitely not something I would normally buy, but due to the fact that we are having, you know, the keto and low carb bread for lunch with the egg salad, for breakfast this week, for dinner, process that, I wanted something else. So I picked up shredded hash browns, but the carbs are not terrible. For someone that's doing low carb, they're not that bad. It's 13 net carbs for 2/3 of a cup, which I feel like is very generous, especially when you're having it with a meal like breakfast for dinner. You know, eggs and bacon, not super carb heavy. So, I picked those up. All right, beverages. I picked up a bottle of rosé. This is the Bogle, Vineyards Rosé. I've had their white wine before and it was decent, and this was only $4.99. So I got that. Again, what more do you expect from me than a 12 pack of hard seltzer? This is the Bon and Viv Spike Seltzer. This is their blends variety pack. So you get lemon lime, pear elderflower, clementine hibiscus, and coconut pineapple. I've had this variety pack before, an eternity ago, and I honestly don't really remember how I felt about it. Bon and Viv in general, I actually do enjoy. They're not my favorite, they're not my least favorite hard seltzer. The only other hard seltzer they had at my grocery outlet was an 8-pack of the Black Cherry White Claw, which I do enjoy, but do you wanna know what I enjoy more than that? Variety. I like having options, so I got this. I really do think I'm gonna start working on a hard seltzer like review video, because at this point, you guys, I have tried so many. I got a new one from Costco that I've never seen before in my life, and it's delicious. So I'm gonna start working on that video for y'all sometime soon. I got 4 bottles of kombucha. Two of these clearly kombucha. I've never had this before. I've never even heard of this brand, and the carb count on these are fabulous. This one is 6 carbs. That's the Asian pear. And then this raspberry lemonade one is 3. I got 2 of the Suja. I used to drink Suja juice a lot pre-keto, so I got 2 of their kombuchas. I got the pineapple heat and the green apple. And then these looked interesting. So Rebel, I have bought their stuff at Whole Foods before, and I saw this and it just caught my eye. It's the vanilla almond keto
like protein drink. The macros on it, you can see 240 calories, 20 fat, 3 net carbs, and 10 protein. So this is intriguing. And then this one is very, very similar. So this is by Remedy Organics, and it's their cold brew keto protein drink. The macros are very similar. You can see 210 calories, 14 fat, 4 net carbs, and 16 protein. Y'all know I'm doing low carb, I'm not necessarily doing keto, but midday I've been having like a protein bar or something similar to that, and you know, as like my snack. And I've, adding on to that though, I've also been low on my fat. So I feel like this will kind of kill two birds with one stone. It'll bump my fat a little bit more than a protein bar would, but I will still get the protein. So I'm eager to try these and let you guys know if they're any good. Okay, aisle items. I'm following a new egg salad recipe this week and it called for a mustard. This was 99 cents. So I got this. Mango and diced mango, diced pineapple for Daisy. It's in 100% juice, so no like weird syrup or any of that stuff. This looked interesting. We are gonna make our own pizzas this week, and this is a spicy tomato sauce. This was 49 cents. The ingredients are really clean. And for 2 tablespoons, it's only 2 net carbs. So picked that up along with some olives for the pizza as well. I found this, y'all know I'm loving on my, what are they called? The sweet leaf, is that what they are? Yeah, the sweet leaf water enhancer drops, but I don't know, this just looked interesting. It was 89 cents. It's the Arizona Mucho Mango, 0 carbs, just another water enhancer to have in there. These were at Grocery Outlet last time I was there, so I picked up 2 more. They were 99 cents a piece. They're the Lily's peanut butter cups. Grabbed 2 of those. Some rice for Daisy, just two packs. These were 99 cents, which is crazy. They're the Annie's white cheddar bunny tails. So they're essentially just like snack crackers that are flavored white cheddar. But anything Annie's for 99 cents, I mean, if it's not macaroni and cheese, you should buy it, because most of their other stuff is, I wouldn't say it's pricey, but it's more than $1. So kind of felt like that was a steal. And then they had my keto bread. So they had my Oasis keto bread. It is the veggie one, but I'm cool with that because I can totally eat the veggie with the egg salad. I've been having the cinnamon raisin chompies with cream cheese, and I think this would also be good with cream cheese on it. So I've only purchased this one other time, and it was by accident, and I was kind of pissed because I was like, I can't really eat peanut butter on like veggie bread. But this for this week, this totally works. I want to note that I did go to Barron's market this week, midweek. It was a couple days ago with my mom. She wanted to see it since it's brand new, and I spent about $45. So like I got produce for Daisy, snacks for Daisy. I bought some more of the One Bars for Sternan and I. So in case you're like, oh, like you didn't buy any bars or you didn't buy any produce, I did get them midweek. Again, not a ton of stuff, but $45 worth. Today at Grocery Outlet, I spent $81. So I am more than happy with that. It's even added on, even adding the $45 onto that, I'm well within, you know, my kind of ideal range of what I like to spend. And yeah, that's it for today's video, friends. Please give this a thumbs up. My hair is driving me insane. I cannot look at it. Please give this a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. Drop me a comment down below. What are you making this week? What are you eating? Where did you go shopping? I always like to know. And there are tons and tons of links down in the description box, resources, books that I, toddler books that I'm recommending, petitions that you can sign that all revolve around what's happening in our country right now. Definitely go check that out. I also added a link for you to click on if you have yet to register to vote. That is also another very important thing that we all need to do, you know, compounded onto the activism that's already happening. So just a PSA on that. And I will see you guys on Wednesday for a What I Eat in a Day, and Friday for a Stitch Fix unboxing and try on haul. I'm so excited. I mentioned a couple of videos ago, I have fallen down the YouTube rabbit hole of Stitch Fix unboxings and try-ons. And so I got a box and I haven't opened it yet because I wanna open it with you guys like on camera. So yeah, keep an eye out for that on Friday, and I will see you guys then. Bye, friends.